Hi there, John Flores again with another chapter. This one is 1975 A&M Records after Kip Cohen decided to split up the group LAX, shelve their album, and offer record deals to two of the singers within LAX, Lynda Seals and Ron Kenoly, who is now for decades a world famous minister. Okay, so I cut four tracks with Lynda. They came out okay. Now, if you listen to the remasters on my website, those four cuts, three in particular being the ballads, they came out great once I remastered them and really made them more powerful. Lynda said at the time, she said, "Don't you think you've become too sweet with your productions over the years?" And boy, was she right. And so I took that into account and I did alter my productions after that. But occasionally things still came out sweet. You know, if you're talking John Flores, who loved big orchestral stuff, and Darnell Pershing, who was my arranger conductor, who was Johnny Mathis's arranger conductor, and then Grover Helsley, who was an orchestral mixing engineer, you're going to have stuff sound maybe a little sweeter than they would with other players in the control room. But Lynda's tracks came out, they weren't promoted, I don't think that I did a marvelous job of mixing them, and I certainly wasn't competitive with those mixes, so I'm really sorry, Lynda, I'm really sorry. But Ron Kenoly's stuff came out great, and oh boy, we tried, we really tried. We had one chart record out of the cuts that we made, it was not a very big chart record, and that was kind of the end of that. But the story that you have not heard goes all the way back to RCA, the National Convention in 1969, when I was 23 years old and stood up in front of hundreds of people at RCA, thanked them for my two gold records with the Friends of Distinction, and then, like the naive rookie I was, said, "And boy, I'd love to see more black faces in this audience." There was kind of a sound in the crowd, and I thought, well, now I've gone and done it, but whatever. So I'm getting ready to leave the conference, and Tom Draper, the head of black product for RCA, comes up, gives me a hug, and says, "John, that won't have done a damn bit of good, but I want to thank you for saying it." Okay, remember, my peers called me over the years the white boy who made Mocha Mix music. And I did. I kind of watered down African-American entertainers and gave them crossover potential, which would be both charts, the pop and the R&B charts. Well, I dealt with Tom Draper for many years, and I recently learned that he passed away a year ago in, I think, January of 2019. Rest in peace, Tom Draper. Socially, I really liked the man. Business-wise, the same guy that hugged me and said, "It won't do a damn bit of good, John, but thanks for saying that," about more blacks working for RCA than there were at the time. But Tom Draper, in essence, cost me a lot of money over the years. And I helped recommend him for the job when Eddie Rosenblatt called and wanted a job recommendation on Tom Draper. I recommended him highly. I don't know if that had anything to do with him getting the job, but I was helpful to Tom over the years, helped create a reputation for him because I had two of his successful acts at RCA on his roster, and then did the recommendation for Warner Brothers with him. And then how this ties together with Ron Kenoly is that at the end of 1975, when we had had no success at A&M with Ron Kenoly's releases, I called Tom Draper over at Warner Brothers, where he was then as the new head of black product for R&B at Warner Brothers, and I said, "Tom, give the album a listen, see what you think." And he called me back and he said, "I really like it, John. Let's talk at the front of the year." This was holiday time at the end of 1975. So I called him back in January and I said, "Tom, how are we going to proceed with that Ron Kenoly project? Do you guys want to buy it from A&M?" And he said, "What project are you talking about?" Oh my goodness gracious. I'm speechless, and I'm speechless to this day. So Ron's album remains on the shelf at A&M, just like all of Lynda's product and all of LAX's product, just basically gathering dust, and that's a shame. Ron Kenoly was a fabulous singer to work with, Lynda Seals. Gosh, I worked with her for, what, 5-7 label deals for over a decade. And love them both. Nothing happened, but I'll show you some highlights from what we did at A&M in 1975, okay? So take a listen. Here are the excerpts. And as always, thanks for watching. Take care.
little bit too much of my time.